Senator from Androscoggin.
Senator Mason.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Mr. President, members of the Senate, no surprise, I am firmly opposed to Medicaid expansion in any form. When the state, this is actually, before we say that, this is a vendor done that proposition. This is a, whom we want, shame on me, shame on you, whom we want, shame on me, and then, as Senator Anderson, and all that. When the state expanded our Medicaid program in the early 2000s, we were told that we do so many things, we lower emergency room visits, it would lower the cost of healthcare, more people would have healthcare, so we would be spending less collectively. But what has really happened? Emergency room visits have doubled. People have not created a relationship with their primary care provider. We've had higher costs, over $1 billion more in spending over the past decade since our last election. And healthcare coverage has remained stagnant. Really been no pressing rise. It did not solve the problem then, and it's not going to solve the problem now. Let me be incredibly clear. I've said it probably four times before this year. This expansion will not be free. The Department of Health and Human Services estimates that should they decide to expand, a minimum of $7 million would be needed to facilitate the administration of this program immediately. That's our share. This cost will be burdened by the state. Also, after the 3-year 100% federal coverage is over, we will then be burdened with another 10% of the program in perpetuity. While 10% may not sound like much, it's estimated to cost roughly $150 million in new spending yearly. And that's from the project. And some of these costs will not be realized for another 20 years in the form of pensions and retired benefits for the new employees that we have to hire to administer the system. Maine will also not receive the deal that other states have received. You see, Maine is being punished by the federal government for doing what we're told to do 10 years ago. The 100% coverage number that's being thrown around is a pipe dream. Better yet, I would consider it a fallacy. We've also been promised matching funds from the federal government before. Since we have expanded our Medicare program, we have seen a decline in the federal match. As a legislator, Mr. President, I would be foolish to expect us to see the 90% match forever, especially when our country is facing a $16 trillion federal debt. And I would contend, Mr. President, with the amendment that's on this bill. I don't believe that this legislature or any future ones will have the stomach to say no to 70,000 people. Finally, and most importantly, the new 70,000 people are coming. We have more than 3,000 people on the 7129 wait list. I've explained before, people with severe cognitive disabilities that need our help, and we've skipped over them again. Maine Care is cannibalizing our state budget. We can no longer write a blank check to DHHS and allow them to spend them with the guise of moral superiority. It's just not right. Someone has to be the adult in the room and say no. We no longer have pots of money to pull from. We must begin to prioritize spending. And this is not the way to do it. Thank you, Mr. President.